So now we're going to go over if statements. So the basic structure of an if statement basically looks like this. It's the keyword if, and then anything inside the parentheses has to be something that evaluates to true or false. You can't just say something like for example, if I say like if like x, so people do this all the time, like if x equals 2. So keep in mind, what you do here is you're initializing the variable x to be 2, because you're saying x equals 2, kind of like what we were doing in the previous ones. You were basically, in that if statement, you're basically doing this line of code right here, which is not what we want to do. What we're trying to do is compare x to the number 2. So how we compare stuff, and most of the time, like how we compare most things, is using this double equal sign. So that basically means does x equal 3, not set x equal to 3, which is one equal sign. So anything inside the statement, inside the parentheses, has to be something that ends up being true or false. So most of the operations you will use is like double equal signs, like less than, greater than signs, because all that will, it will give you a true or false statement in return. And then one common mistake that you'll see is that people will sometimes put semicolons after the if statement, like kind of like how I just drew, and it won't give you an error in that case. But what it does is it checks the condition, and even if it's false, it will still go into this bracket. So basically, even if you have the semicolon there, no matter what, it will run this code, which is, you know, a lot of the times what you're trying to prevent with if statements. So make sure if you're doing an if statement, just if or while loops when we get there. If, else ifs, and while loops will not have a semicolon after them. Because if they do, you know, it'll mess up your code. And sometimes it's hard to catch because it's like one tiny semicolon that's making your code all wonky. So remember, if you have a semicolon, it's always going to run this block of code, which we don't want to do. If we don't have a semicolon, it'll only run the block of code once this is true. So else ifs basically follow the same formatting as ifs. We just have the word else ifs. So you can basically think it's like, if this is not true, then I'll check this condition. And if that's not true, I'll go into the else. Because basically the else means like, if both of these fail, then it will just fall into the, under this category. And else doesn't need to have any parentheses, because it's basically like, you can think of it as anything not checked in these two if statements. So like how this one compares it to x, or x equals to 3, this one's greater than 3. Then that means pretty much any other number, like else is just, it'll go into the else as anytime that x is less than 3. Because equal to 3 is checked here, greater than 3 is checked here. So the only remaining things that it, if it doesn't go into one of these two, the only remaining thing is if x is less than 3. So that's why it will print out this. Because we already did the check to see if x is equal to 3. We already did the check to see if x is greater than 3. So that means the else, anything that falls under the else must be x is less than 3. In this case. And that's why we don't need any parentheses here, because it's basically saying anything that's not this condition or this condition. So can anyone tell me what's the difference between having like an if else rather than two ifs? So what if I just change this else if to just an if? What's the difference than having an else if? Does anyone know?
So both of them are always going to be executed.
Did you say both of them are going to be executed?
Yeah, so if you fail the first if statement, then the second statement wouldn't execute. But in the case I use another if statement, it's going to check the condition. It's going to check the newer condition and then decide whether it should execute or not.
Yeah, essentially. So essentially the difference is, with ifs and else ifs, like let's say that in this case we know that x is equal to 3, so we know that it's going to go into this print statement right here, because x is equal to 3, so it'll print this out. And so what ifs and else if does is that if it goes into one of these, it will not even check the conditions for any other one, so it won't do any of this, and it will just jump to the first line of code after all the if and else if statements. So it'll go to line 18 in this case. But if this was just an if, what it will do is we will say that, you know, x is equal to 3. And then, okay, we will print this out. But since this is another if, that's not like, because an else if is associated with this if. But since it's another if, it's not associated with that if. So it will check this condition again. So let's say that x equaled 4 instead. Let's say that this was if x is greater than or equal to 3. So this block of code should also run if x is 3 as well. So what would happen with an if and an else if is that, with an else if, it'll run this one first because this is the first condition that it'll find true because x is still equal to 3. So it'll print this out. But since it went into this if statement, it won't even check the conditions for all the else ifs. So even though this condition, right, let me erase all this. So even if, so remember this one's in this case greater than or equal to 3. So even though this condition is still technically true, because it went into this if statement, it didn't even check that condition. But if this was an if instead of an else if, so like pretend this was just an if statement, what it will do is it will see that this is true, run this one, but then it will still check this condition and it will see that this one's true as well. And then it will print this one out as well. So it's a small difference, but sometimes it can be a big, it can have a big outcome. Does that kind of make sense? So else ifs, if and else ifs will basically say, is saying that if it goes into one of them, it just doesn't even check the rest of it and just goes to the next line after it. Having multiple ifs means that it will check the condition for each one. And then keep in mind this right here is that you can have an if statement without an else, but you cannot have an else without an if statement. So I could just, like, if I wanted to, I could just have, I could just get rid of all of this and then just have, like, this block of code right here. And then it will still work perfectly fine. All it will do is it will compare this condition, and if that condition is false, then it will just jump to the next line. There doesn't have to be an else or anything, but a lot of times, you know, it's kind of nice to have an else. Any questions on if, else if statement, else statements? Anybody want me to re-clarify anything? So yeah, keep in mind, just no semicolons. I can't think of a single time that you will ever actually need to put a semicolon at the end of an if statement, because then it kind of makes the if statement useless. So just always forget to not put a semicolon there.
Excuse me?
Yeah.
So basically with two, so if you have two if statements, there's an opportunity that it can go through both of them. But if there's an else, it's only going to run through one of those conditions.
Yep, exactly. Okay. So if there's two if statements, it'll check the conditions to both of them. Even if it goes into the first one, it'll still check the condition for the second one. And if that's one's true, it will go into the second one as well. But if it's an if and an else if it goes into the first if statement, it will not go into the else if. It'll just like skip over it. So sometimes you might find more value using two if statements rather than an if and an else if. And I can show you an example of that at the end. So again, we're just going to talk about like the true false operators. So basically, we're basically going to talk about the conditions. So keep in mind that anything inside the parentheses needs to be a true or false condition. So most of the time you'll be using like the Boolean operators, which is like, you know, double equals, which is, you know, we're just checking to see if two things are equal to each other. This is not equal, so we're checking to see if one thing is not equal to another thing. And then we know it's less than or equal to, greater than or equal to. So a lot of times we'll be using these type of operators in some way. So these operators work for all primitive data types. So primitive data types are basically any data type that's just built in. So like integers, doubles, booleans, chars. The only one it does not work for is strings. You can't say like one string equals another string. That's why you have to use like the dot equals or the dot compare to, because it does string, and you'll learn, if you have any more programming classes after this one, you'll learn why string is not a primitive data type and why double equal sign does not work. But just keep in mind, it works for all the other, like all the simple ones, such as like ints, doubles, booleans, and characters. But with strings, we have to do the compare to. But if you even notice in the compare to, we still do a double equal sign. Because what compare to does is just, it finds the distance between two numbers. So if I say like a dot compare to b, it'll give me -1 because A is like one place behind B. So if I say like A dot, like compare to, I'm not gonna write that all out, compare to B, what this will do is it will give me the, it'll give me -1 in return. So if I say like this is less than 0, that means that this value right here, whatever string is right here, is like comes before in the alphabet, before this one. And then greater than is, you know, the opposite. So that's why we do double equals. We want to see if they're exactly the same. So it will only return 0 if like both strings are exactly the same. So that's why you do like dot compare to equals 0, because you're just checking to see if the strings are exactly the same. If you do greater than 0, that means the first string comes after whatever's in the parentheses. If you do less than 0, that means whatever the string in the parentheses or the string before the parentheses comes before it.